Under new management. And I thought, now that's a good text right there. And I just kind of made a mental note of it, but then as we progressed on, and then yesterday and last night, I said, I probably have to talk on that tomorrow. Under new management.
Amen. That's good.
Let's look at it, verse 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away. And behold, all things are become new. Notice some old things that passed away and some things that become new. Sounds to me like it's under new management.
Yeah.
Amen. Under new management. What happens when you're under new management? Things happen. It's different. It's different under new management than it was under the old management. Number one, it's different.
Yeah.
It's different. You don't like the things that under the old, you try to just pass them off under old management. You want to get rid of them, their old habits. I remember when sin got old to me as a sinner, I began to search and seek for the Lord. I was tired of the old management. You know, I was thinking there's all kinds of people, a lot of different kinds of fighters have managers. Sometimes they'll fire a manager and get another. Ball players have different managers. Some of them call them coaches and some of them call them managers, or the same thing. And movie stars even have managers. And singers have managers. And all kinds of managers. And this morning, I fired a manager that I had. He is getting me in trouble. I didn't like the way he was dealing in my life. I didn't like where he was taking me. I knew I was heading for trouble. And I began to realize that if I stayed under his influence, that I was going to be a failure. I needed new management.
Amen.
Now that might not excite you.
Yeah. Amen.
But that excites me. Yeah. I got a new manager.
Yeah.
A brand new manager.
Mm-hmm.
And the old things that I used to do, I gag at them. You won't ever turn to Christ until you get tired of the manager that you got under sin. You see, when you're lost, before you ever get saved, your manager is the devil.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Your manager is old Slewfoot, the flesh. And it was getting me in more trouble than I could ever get out of. Pride and hate and envy and strife and greed. Selfishness. Oh, but thank God I saw some people that had a new manager, and I liked the way their manager operated.
Mm-hmm.
Is this making sense?
Yeah.
I hope it
is.
It's a blessing just to study it. But under the old management, it found out it didn't work. Their attitude changed. When they found out it was new, something about new management that you want to go and check it out.
Yeah.
And so I was excited about this new management deal. And I thought, man, I could use some new management in my life. I could see shipwrecked out ahead. I could see failures. I could see problems. And I said, I'm ready for a new management.
Yeah.
So I fight him. The Lord help me fight this devil. I'm tired of you. I don't want nothing else to do with you. I'm sick of it. I'm tired of your management. You've got me in all kind of trouble. I'm ready for new management.
Amen.
You know, a lot of people hold on to old management just because they're familiar with it.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, We need new management.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. I'm glad I've got new management. You see, some things changed. Not only did I begin to hate sin and failures, and I hated the old management, then I began to see a gospel that I'd never seen before. Under new management, the new management took me into territory that I wasn't familiar with. Amen. But I trusted the manager.
Yeah. Amen.
I said, I'm not going to buck him. I'm going to listen to him, and I'm going to go where he wants me to go. And I found out I could trust him real early and could just rely on him. So I found out there was a love that developed in my heart for the manager, and a respect and confidence. The old manager now is gone. Gone. Out of the picture. Now I'm a new manager, but I'm having a good time with my new manager. He said, all things, old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. I tell you, as I begin to get familiarized with and every other saved person, you see, when you get saved, you got it, sure, but you don't know really what you got. You don't understand it all. You know you've come out, you've got joy, you've got peace, you've got eternal life. You know you've got these things. But you don't know what you've got for everyday living until your new manager steps out and says, here it is. This is the root of the game. Yeah. See, if you're going to play, you're going to have to play with the rules.
Amen.
That's right.
If you're going to play this game of life, you better get familiar with the rule book of life. Yeah. So then we see how the respect for my new manager. And when I experienced his leadership and his presence in my life and his control, I said, you know what? This should be good for everybody.
Yeah, amen.
I got to where I wanted my manager to be your manager. I got to where I wanted my manager to be my kids and my grandkids and my neighbor's kids and the boys I run with. I wanted him to have this manager that I got.
Mm-hmm.
As Kathy sings, oh, what a savior. Can I replace that last part? Oh, what a manager. Oh, what a manager. Praise mm-hmm. God. Amen. And so, I got a love for other people that's in trouble and a failure and the old manager leading them on a dead end street, and the old manager getting them in trouble, the old manager robbing them of life, and the old manager bringing defeat into their life. And I say, hey, praise God, I got a good manager. Won't you try him?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Well. Then here's one. This manager noticed some things. He a good manager will meddle. If he sees something wrong over here, if the running back ain't doing exactly right, and if the man's not dead, he makes some changes. And you see, when things begin in our life, then it's not doing just exactly right, the manager steps in and say, hey, we need to change some things.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Here it comes.
Yeah.
First thing he wanted to do was change some attitudes I had.
Yeah.
We could all stand a little attitude adjustment.
Amen.
You know? Huh? Yeah, some attitude adjustment. This manager said, son, you're going to have to quit getting mad. Yeah, but the Bible says, be ye angry and sin not. I had that worked out, I thought.
Yeah.
But he's talking about there, it's okay to get angry for the right thing. You devil, I hate you, get out of my way, get mad at the devil. But don't get mad at each other.
Yeah.
Don't get mad at the kid. Don't get mad at the wife. Don't get mad at the preacher.
Yeah. Amen.
attitude. This marriage receives some things I've never seen. You see, the Bible says all of man's ways are clean in his own eyes.
Mm-hmm.
But God weigheth up the spirit or the attitude. God looks at our, you see, this thing of salvation, under the law, it dealt with deeds. It dealt with actions. It dealt with conduct. But under the New Testament, you know what it deals with? Attitude.
Mm-hmm.
What is the fruits of the Spirit? Love. That's an attitude.
Yeah.
Joy.
Mm-hmm.
That's an attitude. Long suffering. That's an attitude. You just name them all. Every one of them, it deals with attitudes. Did you know that we hurt each other without an attitude?
Mm-hmm.
Preacher, who are you mad at? I ain't mad at nobody.
Mm-hmm.
If I was going to preach to anybody, I'd say, honey, are you listening to this? I've had it now. But attitudes. Boy, don't we come up with some doozies sometime? We'll go to church, you know, and won't even speak to nobody. Bad night. Leave me alone. Don't even talk to me this morning. Your manager's gonna get you for that if you got the kind of manager, if you got the same manager I got.
Amen.
He won't let me do that. I don't believe he'll let you do that. I don't think you're any different than I am. Oh, what a savior. What a manager. And what I like about him, what y'all thinking, man? Some of you got me, some of you right in here with me, but some of you ain't even touched base with me yet. Reckon you got the wrong manager? Oh, I tell you what, if you've been where I've been, you'll appreciate your manager.
Yeah,
he got me out of a mess.
Yes.
Are you out of it yet? Are you still in it?
Mm-hmm.
Attitudes. Mm-hmm. Boy, I knew I'd done hit a, when I hit them attitudes, I hit a snag. I seen it on everybody. Couldn't we? I think we all could stand a little attitude adjustment.
Amen.
Including the man in the pulpit. I'm not, if you ever notice me when I'm preaching, one finger this way and three back this way. The only advantage I've got, I've done preached this two or three times in the night last night. I done had time to get right. That's God to forgive me, help me to change. Man, he worked on my attitude. I learned to love people instead of being afraid of them and criticizing them and being on guard against them. You know, before I got saved, I thought everybody was gunning for me. Nobody liked me, and I was born on the wrong side of the street. And I was a Kofer, and nobody's supposed to love Kofers. I just thought that I had a bad attitude. I didn't even know I had a bad attitude. But oh man, when he started to work on me, I didn't like it. I didn't like it when you start pointing out my attitude. You start pointing out people's faults and you'll get in trouble.
Amen. Really?
I ain't got a bad attitude. It's you's got the bad attitude. You ever heard of husband and wife fussing?
Mm.